Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Blank Check here, and today we are in for a long ride. Welcome back to Bronies React. There are several of these that I have not seen, but if you thought I was going to keep up the integrity of their chronological releases, you are sorely mistaken. Did you know they made a My Little Pony movie? Yeah, they tried to sneak it in under our noses, but I noticed, and apparently Race did too. And he got a group together to react to the thing. And hopefully that doesn't cause any problems with Lionsgate. But yeah, this thing flew into theaters, 20 million domestic, 60 million worldwide. Probably pretty decent given the budget. And the film wasn't bad. It wasn't amazing, but it was fun. Nice visuals, catchy tunes. I think they forgot Fluttershy and Applejack were characters, but whatever. Now here we are, a year and change later, Race has gotten together a merry band of commentators. I don't know who exactly is in this one. I assume with something this big that our core players will be around. ACRaceBest, SaberSpark, Black Griffin, Viva, likely Jaxblade. And thanks to Twitter, I do know who the special guest is this time around, and it's pretty interesting. Anyway, they made a really long video. Why? This will be, I think, the longest video on my channel, so let me take a deep breath before going crazy for an hour and a half. No talking during the movie, no texting, turn off your cell phones. And now, your feature presentation. Alright, here we go. In a world...
They said the day would never come. Considering all the universe's possible eventualities,
I love
this outcome is an impossibility.
Viva's spirit in these.
An immortal observer able to view life from its genesis all the way to present day, able to view every outcome, every distinct thread of possibility this universe has to offer.
He's a good way to start this off.
A single one of them would believe we not only could, but that we eventually would be able to live in this world today.
He's got the chops for a skit like this.
The day where not only could an intelligent life begin to flourish, where not only could this intelligent life wish to entertain its species with consumable media, where not only would an episodic show with a target demographic consisting of a very small percentage of beings in this species could begin to grow.
We are.
Not only would this growth eventually surpass its initial demographic
on the cosmic scale,
become a worldwide phenomenon, but that this growth would lead to this show, despite all.
Oh, I see it.
And despite the objective statistical impossibility, get.
I'd love to see him pull out the movie on like a UMD.
Would never come that you could say you watched a cinematic My Little Pony movie.
We truly have reached
the 1986 film.
Peak evolution here, guys.
Today is that day. The day they said would never come.
There's nowhere to go but down.
To watch My Little Pony. Wait, what? Are you kidding me? Do you know how many times the planets aligned to make this happen, and this is what you have to show for it?
My Little Pony. I think I saw that.
How do you make such an obscenely rookie mistake? This is complete disrespect. I don't believe it. I swear.
It's time they have a doctorate
watch.
In that disrespect, I hear.
Little Pony, the movie. For Christ's sake.
Here we are. Yes, get the reel going. Projector 410. Oh, that would be a pretty cool idea. Having a Mystery Science Theater style episode of MLP, that'd be really weird.
Guys, the My Little Pony movie just
Gabe!
Came out. It's 2017, we're all so excited to watch it. Let's watch
yeah.
it.
Yeah! Gabe has rabies right now, or had recently.
It's time.
Yeah, a little shy, okay. And paleo. Makes sense.
This movie right here.
Finally, after all these years, after such humble beginnings as the silly little meme on the internet, we have our very own cinematic release.
Hey, everybody.
I like seeing Little Shy's Blue Yeti.
Best friend SaberSpark.
Makes me think of my own. Saber!
In theaters, it was a ton of fun.
What's up, bud? I haven't seen you in a while.
I'm actually genuinely excited to watch this again.
What's so special about this setup? Well, have I got a surprise for you.
Donkey Konga!
In Equestria!
Oh my god.
The portal.
That's great.
None of you get to see it, because it's in Australia.
Eat your heart out, Saber. Okay, Silvercrow's still there.
No one can shush me.
Actually, I lied. Where I actually am is... Ah! Oh.
Pea soup!
Ladies and gentlemen, ACRaceBest
here big fog.
Another Bronies React, and this one
hey,
is
Race,
one,
stop stealing my thunder here.
It is the movie.
Ladies and gentlemen, AC Race Best here.
Like season one or season two, you know, the earlier seasons, like wondering what would come of this silly little show. And here we are, all these seasons later, all this great times and conventions.
All this money poured into...
It is time to...
Inanimate objects. Toodles! Yay!
What are you doing on the couch?
That's a cool popcorn bucket.
So, let's do it. Let's talk about the My Little Pony movie.
You know one thing that'll be nice about this? Is they probably won't have the theme song. So for once, I wanted to try and think of something clever.
I was actually fooled a little bit by those backgrounds on his upper monitors.
Australian dude with Legolas hair.
It is time.
For a second, I thought it might be a window. And I feel really bad about myself.
My Little Pony, the movie.
That's an interesting mouse. Lion's Gate, not Pony's Gate.
There are no lions in Equestria.
Actually, Pony's Gate sounds like a really bad sucks. Internet.
Doesn't know how to advertise.
Explosion.
They change it to Pony's Gate.
Hey, he said the thing.
Spark Pictures, huh? Just like Optimus fucking Prime. That's awesome.
Yeah, Jax is here. All right.
He is one with the All Spark.
I saw Bumblebee. It was pretty good.
Look at that sparkle.
Who is this? The star of the movie?
I mean, if it transforms into Twilight, yes, but otherwise...
We're speeding up! Yes! Here we go!
They're really milking this opening. What were you doing?
I mean, it could be like a Raimi Spider-Man opening, and that spark just goes something all over the place.
But also exciting about this opening logo here.
I gotta say, this instrumental
yeah, the glitter.
Is actually, like, really good.
Now, I don't have actual glitter with me, but I can do the next best thing.
Glitter all over me.
You know, why make new scenes when you got the stuff to reuse? Mr. Tong is in the house.
Okay.
Here to steal yo waifus.
We'd review the episodes, but here it is, the theme song in movie format.
American Pie. I get it. The shirt. I like it.
Wait, what's
I want Vincent Tong to have, like, the most sincere and relatable reaction of them all.
Happening?
The first pony we see in this movie is Mohawk Pegasus Applejack.
No, it is.
Keep on walking down the street.
Starting out with a song
there it is.
Parody, that's pretty weird.
Copyright claim.
It is really weird, given that it's the only one in the movie. Like, every other one, they had an original song. Why would they start with this?
We got the beat, we got the beat,
we got the beat!
Oh yeah, this opening really makes me hype for the movie.
We got the hooves!
I gotta say, this song here at the start...
We got the wings!
...song the entire film. Daniel Ingram really outdid himself here.
Yeah, really honing his 80s.
...song for this movie. Daniel hired me to do to sing the demo for this. And then it came with a different song. So instead of having original music, they decided to do a cheesy cover of We Got the Beat.
Don't tell me that.
Which is fine with me.
That just makes me sadder. It makes me more disappointed in Now It Opened.
How does one do the pony? None of that.
Hey, that's Drew Scanlon of Giant Bomb, previously like, now on
they call it, but it's the animation
Something Map
Treasure Planet, where they stretch a drawing over a 3D map.
He does video game documentaries in foreign countries. It's pretty cool.
Shoutouts to Candlelot. Shoutouts to the pony that looks like Viva. Shoutouts to this pony being really hard to key out because it's also green and I'm on a green screen. Shoutouts to me.
I bet he can make a pretty good skit. Professional. Like one of his original videos with that pony in the background.
This plushie again.
No, please use it every time. I like it.
Sanitary.
Every pony from Manhattan to Saddle Arabia is here.
I know, Philly. We almost couldn't book a stable.
Horse puns.
Oh no, it's gonna be bad.
Look, it's like a lot of people's intro to the series. So you have to fill in all the puns
like
you can.
Named Philly in this world would be like somebody just naming their kid, which actually happens.
Yeah, I knew a guy named Guy down the street growing up.
Animation's very different.
Something about the noses and the eyes, just I can't place exactly what it is, but they stick out to me in a way where I'm just like, eh.
Princess Twilight must have her.
I like the designs in the movie.
Are you kidding?
I'm Diet Rainbow.
Those little noses are cute.
There's nothing she can't have.
Is that foreshadowing?
There's actually a lot that Twilight probably can't handle. I'm sure Silver Quill will probably have something
like
to
cut
say
the narrator.
That.
She didn't handle it.
In before AC Race Best puts in that scene from Zootopia.
Yeah.
Who made that joke?
That was kind of gross.
You see, she can't handle it.
At this point, I want it to be so meta that someone is referencing someone else referencing the joke. Give me two layers of that.
I've been waiting for this Bronies reaction.
Knowledge.
You're welcome, authenticity police!
Gabe, you're breaking the camera.
Her crown?
The animation is reminiscent to Disney.
The animation throws me off.
Yeah.
In this, it's so weird.
I'm not sure.
It's different.
I'm happy with the amount of.
But it's welcome.
Original show style, like. I think almost like the character models are rounded more than I'm used to.
Oh, definitely rounded.
I still like it. I'm not.
Tori, please do not step on my keyboard, girl.
What you talking about?
What you talking about, Twilight?
I'm about to ask the three most royal.
Come on, baby, go down. Oh God.
Huge favor.
You're about to ask the only three
good girl.
Princesses besides yourself.
And then there's that fourth not as royal princess.
Sorry, I had to move a cat.
I will never be royal.
Yeah.
You can call me Celestia. Okay, I just want to show you all. The way this works in Equestria.
Faux Cinder made a parody cover of Royals. It's pretty cool.
Oh, yeah. Soldiers, you know, soldiers
look it up.
In an important position. You need bakers, like Pinkie Pie, to make food.
It's about Twilight, I mean.
Of Equestria. Farmers, like AJ, you need them to make the food for the bakers to bake so the soldiers can eat, so Celeste can boss them around. And then right here, you got janitors, you know, you got people who need to clean up.
Like Spike!
All of Equestria, you need them. And then next is a pile of poop.
Oh, there's Spike, sorry.
Because those things are around, so you might step in them.
Wait.
And then below that is the Prince of Friendship, Twilight Sparkle.
Just remember them.
And then her helper, Spike.
Smile?
Yeah, you should smile more, Twilight. Girls like hearing that, right?
Big smile.
He's going lesson zero on us.
Twilight's oversaturated with the smile song as well.
You're a princess too.
If anyone wanted to reanimate lesson zero in Toon Boom, I'd welcome it.
You're a princess too.
You see, I'm calling back to a previous Bronies React, like way back, like what, like 5 years ago? Damn, it's been a while.
I like the way.
It's been a long time, Paleo.
Right.
Twilight Sparkle, right now. That is not our strong.
I have an idea that I think will make our friendship.
Why is that the sound bite?
Equestria has ever seen.
Say an orgy, and I'll say no over you.
Strip haircut.
Orgy. You asshole.
Yes, Twilight. We are very.
You got me this time, Reese.
Shut up, Twilight.
I have lived for thousands of years and have seen things you can't begin to imagine. Yes. I am very excited for your little friendship party.
Ponies have been arriving from all over all morning.
I want to boogie down.
I'd like to think it's to see us, but Songbird Serenade might be the bigger attraction.
Twerking only becomes popular once every thousand years, Twilight.
True. We're here for that pop star that we only just now heard of.
I gotta work this while it's good. Good.
$5 million budget on celebrity cameos.
Yes, she is the main event.
That's a bit of money, Gabe.
More horse puns!
It's funny because.
Stop telling me statistics about the film because I'm.
If the movie doesn't lay off the terrible
puns, I want to respect the production here.
Bronies react.
Oh, forgive me. I've been a little hoarse as of late, and not to steer up all the gallery. Fucking puns. I hate puns. I can't do it.
Princess Celestia?
I feel like you have the capability, Saber.
Precise precision. That sounds redundant.
I want to see you at your worst.
Equals Charlie, the integral of Pinkie Pie times Vinyl plus Octavia. Those arrows look like sperms.
Yeah.
Don't they?
Why?
You have a dirty mind.
Would reflect the sunlight.
You're a terrible person.
And really frame the entire stage perfectly.
Yeah, we throw hearts in there. God,
we've got to get you a date.
We transplant some things.
Forward explanation is meant to be confusing, but I literally am confused.
How does astronomy even work in this?
It's funny how it works out that way.
What?
I have no idea.
But wait, there's more.
Order now.
We use the gravity of the sun.
Festival for free. Just pay shipping and handling.
Cadence, if you could use your crystal magic to create an aurora.
Crystal magic.
Have you seen Interstellar?
Make people fall.
If we just fold space and then move through it in two dimensions, then we warp.
You want us to move the sun and the moon for the party.
You've done it before for improv musicals.
I mean, if you're worried about the tides, she screwed that up ages ago.
Look, we're pretty much out of water by this point, so.
I don't have your magic.
I like.
That was cute.
I really like the snort.
Piggy went to Celestia.
It's such and a good moment.
Piggy went to the moon.
And she did have their magic wand, and she was doing this.
Oh, that didn't work.
Forth back in time, so it is pretty interesting and funny to hear them talk about it.
You already have all the magic you need.
Friendship isn't enough magic.
I mean, yeah, but I could also go with moving the sun and moon at the same time. That's
sun, which you do like every day for one event to help Twilight. It's like, you know what, Celestia. Next time Equestria is on fire, don't come to me to help you. You're on your own. You're on your.
Why don't you ask your Luna friend who can move the tides to put out the fire?
Magic you need. I am the princess of friendship, and my magic says that you need to use your magic to move the sun and moon.
Well, we are at an impasse.
Well, my magical sword says it will gut you dry if you.
Discord balloon farting joke. I approve.
I'm guessing that's the only disc
top quality
we're gonna get.
Any fart jokes, really.
That's one cheap.
You know,
way to get a cameo.
You know what? I can work with that. Mr. Tong, you have my respect.
Is that front row all Angry Birds? Angels pretending to be a bird.
Free samples of my family.
That was a nice addition.
Anybody want some of that apple beer?
I'm an alcoholic. I'll have some. And the lesbian.
Isn't it really cute when the ponies look down like this?
Like Rarity here?
No, she looks stoned.
What does Rainbow Dash have to say about it?
Darling, once they legalized it, I was all over that.
She brings a fair point.
Wow, Rarity.
Oh, hello, Applejack. Where's Rainbow Dash? Here. Where's Pinkie Pie? Applejack.
Has anyone seen Spike the Dragon?
Jack, darling, I'm not thinking it's platonic.
Assistant, baby dragon assistant to Twilight Sparkle around here.
Rainbow Dash's speed work. So, for example, like, is it like the Flash or Quicksilver from X-Men Days of Future Past where everything just slows down and she's able to just...
I would love to see a scene like that, actually.
4 seconds flat.
Like if she gets hyped up on caffeine and goes, like the coffee from Futurama, 100 coffees.
Raised in a barn.
No offense.
Full offense, Applejack. Who was raised in a barn?
That was also a pretty good joke, gotta say.
Where I was born and spent most of my formative years.
I have seen this a few times.
I can't top that.
And on today's episode of Everybody Hates Applejack.
I understand the Flash and Superman can have like this whole detailed talk when they're just like speeding so fast with each other. But is she even like enjoying just...
Hey,
I want Jack's Blade to never stop talking about this one concept
with those kinds of jokes
for the next hour and 15 minutes.
Stone like...
In her mouth?
What the fuck?
Poor Fluttershy.
It's like a bib.
I can't do my girl like that.
Hi, Rarity.
Look, just you wait, Jax. You'll see how they don't do anything with her.
Thwing!
Camera had panned down just slightly. We would have seen something that would have changed the rating of this film.
If I failed the festival, then who am I?
Who am I?
Gaze into the face of madness.
I forget his number. I would have like said it out loud.
You are bad at this.
Script writing 101 says... To introduce somebody by how they act and not necessarily by talking to the camera and saying that that's how they act. Let's celebrate.
Yeah, show don't tell.
Okay.
She's having a screaming orgasm.
Yeah, we all party.
Fluttershy's still, she's waiting for her turn.
What she didn't do is smoke a cigarette at the end.
What did you say? What jokes didn't you want this to be filled with?
You want views on your video?
I didn't say anything. No censorship, please.
First song.
Quote Toodles.
That phrase did not work for Gloriosa Daisy.
Yeah, let's just ignore that movie. That wasn't canon. It. They're humans. Who cares?
Well,
if only Spike had wings.
And the clouds are dark and gray. Just kick them off.
Icarus.
Her wings just melt.
That's a great message, but
that's a weird sight.
99% of Equestria's population is going to be useless in this movie.
Whoa!
Ooh, that's what the magic does.
Them sexy pouty lips.
That looks like fan art that you can find at a convention.
Yeah.
We got this together.
Yay, it's so nice.
Hold up, that's not even a subtle Twitter reference.
She's so good.
Why is that there?
Was that it for Fluttershy's part?
She's trying to make tweets make sense.
Hey, Apple Bloom! Hey, Michelle, you told me you weren't in this movie!
This is pan over to a cardboard cutout of Miss Kreeber.
$2,000 paycheck.
Was that introduce one line in this movie.
Like, Peter New nailed it. He deserves that money.
The movie had like the same songs as like the show, where it's just like, oh yeah, this is pretty good.
He's got to fund his indie films.
I wish I worked in real life. Painting the house, painting the house, and I'm done. Chicken
one or two. I mean,
what a fatso.
Worked in Red Dead Redemption 2.
That's not nice. Promise to bring ponies together
and never let any pony. Going under the arch is worth like 20 points. Nice job, Twilight.
That is the most concrete statement she's had about her role since she got wings.
Yeah, I really like this movie for its spectacle, you know? I mean,
yeah.
I've been complaining about the writing all day, and I think I'm about to. It's just so much fun.
We got 70 minutes to do so.
Twilight just flies away from the rest of the
But it is pretty!
Imagine, like, AJ being
There's
like,
some cool set pieces.
Work together. Hey, where'd she go? A lot to bake. Each
pony needs a piece of cake. Ooh, she's I love the she's tempo sweating. Change. Really when it moves cool. to her in this song.
Hey, sweet Alpern.
This is also the song where we get all the fan service out of the way with all the background characters.
Yeah. We're here to satisfy everyone before we disappoint them all.
I'm glad they did this, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pinky is so friggin' adorable.
Better than not doing it whatsoever.
Like, look at her eyes. I just want to hug her.
It's the festival of friendship.
I have a headache just watching. Derpy!
Shouts to Derpy.
Ah, Muffin Mayor.
Where's that little shy?
Freak out.
Derpy.
Yeah.
That is all. Weather, the
banquet, the star. He's going crazy. Yeah, what's her face? What?
A shot's so
I don't understand.
She just got caked.
And you killed your main character.
Ah, there's the
Is this cake by the ocean?
Oh my god, his heart's noise says, Nay!
Is it really her?
Nay. That guy, I love that guy.
Pony's a cameo. I need to set up
for my sound check. Well, if a horrible
I mean, and her bodyguards are cameos.
Better during the sound check than during the main
or,
event, right?
Are they just references?
This is why we have these things.
How do we distinguish? Visual
confirmed. Go for cleanup. Does the cake look like a bitch?
Ponies.
Oh, I
That's all you had to say, pony.
LJ from the movie The Negotiator.
Oh, here comes the MacGuffin! I like it. It's day after tomorrow.
Enter villain. Yeah, independence. Yep, interdependence.
That sounds like a complaint somebody would have at Disneyland or Disney World. Rainbow
Dash. Did someone call one Sombra?
Rainbow Dash. I don't think those are storm clouds. Today's forecast is cloudy with a chance of conflict.
Those aren't storm clouds. Those are
cloudy with a chance of totalitarianism.
Make a fern gully the whole time.
It's my favorite.
Villain is global warming.
You know, actually, the shaking of the camera is a little satisfying. That was good.
I was gonna make a joke about how the ship kind of looked like it was from a PS1 game, because I remember it looking like it was from a PS1 game.
But I don't want to be mean to the movie.
I don't think it does anymore. I might be crazy.
The only real complaint I have about the animation is the 3D. I
bet those are the clowns I ordered! The 3D clowns that I ordered.
Jack's Blade's gonna hate this if they're clowns.
I too remember the killer clowns of 2016.
No!
In a better place now. Balloon heaven.
Moment of silence.
I don't know.
Helium hell.
There we go, helium.
It's one of those things from...
It's better than I would have come up with in a half a second I had. Thank you, Gabe.
The Angry Birds movie where the pigs first show up.
Look, let's not talk about that. Let's just... Don't make me think of that.
I think it's a metaphor for the fact that the movie starts off so lighthearted in tone. And from this point forwards, it transforms into a more darker tone, more than you would expect from a My Little Pony TV show movie.
Are you saying this movie was more than meets the eye and transforms?
It's funny because of Hasbro's monopoly on famous toys, including Monopoly.
I think it's
Oh yeah,
really
I have
deep.
That, I own that. Can we like fit Ouija into this somehow? Because I am totally down for that.
It was actually pretty likable.
Storm King.
Give me some D&D. Well, we have that in the actual show, but
say about this.
Storm, yeah.
To deliver the evil, evil message.
This is how Hasbro introduces every investor meeting.
Michael Peña, why do you have to do this to me? You're so good in Ant-Man. You're so fun.
One look at her and I can tell she's compensating for something.
Blunt.
I'm John Krasinski's wife. I'm also really good in Edge of Tomorrow. Look it up.
This was
also, everyone, Edge of Tomorrow, great movie. Called Live, Die, Repeat Now. Once it came to physical media. Emily Blunt is great. I love her. A Quiet Place is a fantastic film. Mary Poppins was a lot of fun. All right.
Finally, canonically confirms that the My Little Pony characters are not made of marshmallow. Damn it.
Actually, that's Emily Blunt.
Darn, I really wanted to make s'mores with Rarity.
Holy shit. Tempest isn't a unicorn. Because she's a unicorn.
Huh?
What?
She's not a unicorn. She's a unicorn.
Oh no. Stop.
Did you
please
hear that, like, jet engine sound when they landed?
How may
the superhero landing.
How may we help?
Celestia is Iron Man,
so
pretty much.
Glad you asked. How about we start with your complete and total surrender?
They are both played by Robert Downey Jr.
She did ask really nicely.
I mean, and I asked her what she wanted.
Yeah, I kind of walked into that one.
Yeah, it was just a recommendation.
Celestia, Luna, Cadence. Alicorn, OP powerful. We saw how powerful Twilight was during the Tyrek fight. I do not understand how any of this is just even possible.
Yeah, they got some one for all power going on. Just want to note it. Jack's Blade shirt. My Hero Academia. Great show. Watch it.
I know we can talk things out.
This is why you're being taken over in the first place, Twilight.
All four princesses.
All four princesses?
Also, those who prefer dubs. Really good dub.
Here's the deal, ladies.
I'm going to be your antagonist for this movie. I hope you understand.
I need your magic. Give it up nicely, please. Or we make it difficult. Forever.
You know, but the secondary antagonist, the one that, you know, turns good.
To be yours. She has a broken horn. Her magic's probably not gonna do.
Just wanna put that out there from the beginning, so there's no surprises.
Condescending look all the time, where her chin is always up, like pathetic.
I was hoping you choose.
This is like
difficult.
Wrong choice. She's got a blimp full of monsters.
The American's image of the upper class British nobility channeled into a pony.
Oh no, it's the Minions!
I was hoping it would be the little yellow guy's sounds.
Karate kick, a green ball.
This orb thing she's kicking is pretty badass too.
Despicable Me, that's the name of it.
Help from the Queen of the Hippo!
Boom! She got hit!
Oh no, somebody's attacking us! Quick! Luna! Go and I should have seen this coming!
Why were you explaining it so slowly?
You'd think there'd be some.
Like, Luna needs to take her time to understand.
And talk to you for like a minute about this stuff when we should have had a contingency plan.
Also, couldn't they just like teleport out of there like immediately?
See, Celestia thought she was in an anime. Oh, they're usually kind enough to let you talk exposition for like 5 minutes before they do anything.
Rock type attacks.
Nice effect.
Hey, don't laugh. You'd be short one princess if not for Twilight.
This whole thing right now, them being attacked and set in stone, like, if Starlight and Discord showed up right
yeah,
now...
Yeah, like, Starlight
this movie would be
just
over.
Not here, out on, I guess...
No, that's Derpy.
A conference.
The hero of a question.
To the Yak Land.
So Derpy literally just saved the day for our main characters. So cut to Little Shia being really happy right here.
I love the sound design and the music during this whole action scene. If you're not listening with high-quality headphones or a subwoofer or something, you're missing out on half the experience.
Well, I mean, it was a good guess, wasn't it?
Derpy, you're the hero we need, not the one we deserve.
That's fan service!
Yet. Derpy is not a princess yet.
Derpy!
Yeah, just you wait. Season 9. There's plenty of time left.
Here, y'all. We're going this way!
No, no! Over here! Over here!
Quick, find the princess! We're over here!
I hope they don't shoot over this direction.
The world that can resist magic.
approximately 22 degrees northwest.
Like really well animated.
Yeah. It's pretty fucking good.
I just had a hearty meal, and I will.
The water's great.
I will side cramp.
Come on in. Water's fine.
Ready.
Another good riding tip, they didn't use the.
You didn't hate him 10 minutes ago?
Dead. They survived some pretty stupid things in this show.
Oh, thank goodness. I don't believe that Applejack was dead.
I think my bottom's on backwards.
Well, I was more concerned about the safety of the hat. Screw the horse. I mean, if that hat didn't find a home, it'd be the big tragedy.
We still have a chance. Maybe Rarity is the only one made of marshmallow.
Now what? We can't hide here forever.
You're saying there's a chance.
It's that Brony just laser focusing.
But what about Twilight? What about my wife? How's she feeling in all this?
More importantly, how is her butt?
Yeah, specifically.
Is it on backwards too?
Find the queen of the hippos.
I need to make sure the shapeliness is still there.
If I don't get hippos before movie's end, I will not be happy.
Did I hear that right?
Hungry. Hungry?
Hippos?
Oh no!
Everyone collectively sigh.
Hasbro product!
Give me everyone being sad.
I actually did that!
Now make a Clue reference.
Wow, that is shameless and yet I love it. That's really funny.
Still funny.
Yeah, it is.
No. Bad Hasbro.
Spirits. Go to your room. Which direction should we go?
You know, they'll be sending in a Twister. And then
H-
a Monopoly on all Equestria.
M.
Shut up, Fluttershy.
Remember when
down to the ombres.
Let's bring the Flutteryay back.
Days since last time Fluttershy said yay. Zero. Days since last time Fluttershy spoke. Zero.
Look, it's a timeless, timeless thing.
We just watched the hostile invasion of Canterlot.
Unfortunately, she won't speak
Why
ever again.
Be cutesy. I mean, what's next?
That's what Disney do. Tragedy followed by levity.
Something that is colorblind.
Look it up. One of the saddest openings ever.
That's depressing.
The little chubby kid with his balloons.
All this power.
I haven't seen Up in a while.
Wasted on parties.
As opposed to world domination? I mean, are those the two choices?
Are you serious? She hasn't changed the default ringtone on her bioluminescent.
I like it. I actually looked at my phone because for some reason, even though that's not my ringtone at all, I looked over at it.
Not only are there ringtones, but the ringtones come with these potions. These potions.
And I did get a text at least.
And therefore, they have sets of ringtones.
Oh God!
Real ringtones.
At first, looked like he was behind himself, reaching into his face to just end himself. Nice. I love what he was doing here. Always puts in the work.
In there the first time, and the second and third and.
I didn't realize before that
the dial-up. Yeah, it's so good.
Over here. No.
How many of you are old enough to remember the dial-up tone?
Hello, Hades.
Does he remind you in a little way?
I mean, next election, people born after 9/11 are going to be able to vote for president. That's crazy.
In the middle of a big rebrand here.
How many little, like, Hasbro jokes can they fit in here? That the Storm King is Hasbro.
Twig.
That would be the staff of Sakon.
That's one thing I do respect, is that the writers
another stick from the desert.
Put it's Hasbro like in as the villain, in essence.
Glimmer, starlight glimmer about that one.
The staff of Selene.
The spear of Selene.
The staff, the Selene of the spear.
The spear of Selene was never a spear.
Spoilers.
Yeah, sounds pretty good.
Have the power of 100
accurate.
You steamroll 3 of the 4 princesses. I think you're overrating them.
Why is she comparing her power to that of military strength?
That's true.
Doesn't he already have that?
Do you think, like, Storm King, like, saw Tyr-
they have troops.
Sombra do their thing.
What are the ponies gonna do against them? Nothing.
And you're locking down the 4 Pegacornicuses.
He's an honor.
Like, the regular ponies got nada.
Power to make you whole.
I don't understand how magic works in this universe. It's, implied...
Is that misogynistic, that Mr. Storm King?
Horn being broken means that she, in a way, is broken. Whether it is emotionally, which I think is the case, she seems quite capable, if not superior, to the rest of the unicorns and the main 6 and everybody else. It
yeah.
must be more of an aesthetic change.
She still kicks butt.
Horn.
Maybe that's her symbolism.
You know, great sex shop for that.
Work, and you'll get your
penis back.
You know, she went through a
and your horn won't be the only thing that's broken.
Crippling mental and physical tragedy, but she's even stronger, all the stronger for it.
Yeah, he does. He reminds me of the Anastasia villain.
Sorry, bad spell service. You want me to call him back?
That's funny.
This is
that is it's that's a decent pun. That is an okay pun.
Tiny, tiny bit funny.
Sponge cake.
Can I get that on a loop?
Can we add some skeletal structure in there? X-ray vision.
I need all four to put the Megazord together. Hey, that's relevant because Hasbro bought Power Rangers.
And you know you don't look good at
hair. Did not know that.
Weird line.
Today I learned.
That princess is not going to keep me from getting my horn back.
I'm really liking the animation of this.
Her face goes crazy throughout this entire scene. It's great.
Oh, that's cute.
That's a dead thing.
Yeah, what the heck?
That thing could probably talk when it was alive.
TMI rarity.
The people in my life are like grains of sand, cause they stick together, often in my butthole.
Ew.
The ones with wings kind of just...
Thrall were just dust
they
in the wind.
To stick together.
I have sand in everything.
My bum's on backwards!
We're lost?
All orifices. That's a good word.
How did critics not like this movie?
And she died!
She cracked first, but I secretly suspected Fluttershy.
Like, Fluttershy can tough it out when need be.
He looks like the Spike from the Dot Mob series.
I like this anime.
He exactly does.
No, I got even that shot right there!
It is the Dot Mob!
It is Hot Diggity Demon to a T.
Spike has some, like, really great expressions here.
It looks really funny.
I can multitask.
That Spike's done drugs.
Multiple things badly.
Well, that cactus had drugs inside of it.
Highest bidder.
It's like Sokka when they were stuck in a desert.
That's dark.
Those look like those bad guys from Zelda Wind Waker.
Moblins? Bacoblins?
Wait, go back. Did it?
Yeah. Just randomly. I love those guys.
Why?
You with the horn.
It's hot there.
Like Tempest did.
You just fall over. It's what you do.
Around my merchandise. Easy there, Gamera.
Yeah, there you go. Wait until she's done helping you to tell her off.
Very interesting.
Godzilla King of the Monsters coming soon, guys.
Of him in rarity there is.
Looks pretty.
So I guess it's understandable. It is a Tay Diggs cat.
We just gotta stick together. Be careful who you talk to and try to blend in.
We just
all these people look
together.
Fishy.
Those floppy ears, the tails, the scales. Girls, I think we're at a furry convention.
Fucking
ah! Part of the ship. Part of the
it's terrible.
Excuse me, Pinky. It's every creature. Do you see?
I've been to one. It's just a color explosion.
You gotta get something.
Well,
how much something do you want there, big boy?
Never used.
That'll be 20 bits.
You can't just take off.
It's like one of your friends
per
like,
hour
off in Baltimore during BronyCon. It's like you just can't take off in this place.
Totally got this.
Yep.
That.
How much for the giant gecko?
Oh, wait a minute. You'd pay 5 bits for my dragon? Sold, no question.
Wow, was he worth that much this entire time?
Rarity, where did you get the hair products to get your hair back? Did you get a comb? Did you get a brush?
Yeah, she stole that comb. Ooh. You know she did. She swiped it with her magic.
Everyone at BronyCon, which by the way did not have many party cannons, disappointed.
I have all 7 for my collection.
Hey, there's one more BronyCon. Maybe they'll bring out the big guns, literally, this time.
Hasbro thinks of us, guys? This scene right here.
Wow, they included Spike. That's weird.
Look at all those colors. You think that's natural?
Hey, that's Spectralist.
We're trying to make it more marketable.
Don't worry.
Applejack just had a pussy in her mouth.
Stop.
As long as you're not...
Stop.
Ew, tag your pomegranate.
Stop.
Butt wipe.
Parts will fall off.
Did he just make a penis joke?
100%.
You know it.
Impossible to interpret that scene.
TVY 7.
Way.
It is what went through my mind first.
I don't know why you grabbed down there. I just meant your fins would fall off.
The thing he immediately grabbed was his crotch.
I can't believe they did that. Like,
look,
here I am thinking
you know,
being
accurate representation.
Like, jokes about wieners.
Okay.
Of a concerned individual.
The interspecies thing isn't a problem here.
Don't fuck the cat, Rarity.
We already knew that, though, because
Twilight. One handsome-ass man right there. Tay Diggs, you get your pony ass, whatever you do.
What more she suddenly brought up the fact that she's kind of raising a cat as a pet.
He looks like a little
you know,
Vegeta.
I want to see that. I want to see Rarity take him home
I had no
and then him see Opalescence.
Ever. Like, this is the first time hearing his name.
And those two run away together in a weird twist.
I just lost the game.
Would you all like to see the van with
kind of creepy elope
we should trust him.
Moment.
Racist bitch.
Definitely you can friend out here.
But he's a famous celebrity cameo.
If I do say so myself.
And most of the ones in this movie are bad.
This town.
Like bad people.
Nice place.
Second
bad characters. Asterisk, asterisk.
I actually got to do a scratch track.
Uh-oh, we got another song coming.
Oh, really?
What's he got to say?
Daniel Ingram actually asked me to sing the song that he wrote for this show as like a demo.
For little fillies. Well,
that's cool. Nice behind the scenes here.
There are lots of twists and corners.
I like the Rainbow Dash's shimmy to the side.
So it's Jersey.
It's really cool seeing it live for the first time.
I'm the friend
yeah.
that you need when you're lost and don't know what to do. I'm a pal, your amigo.
He's not the friend we
nice.
Deserve.
Nice. I would listen to a if he uploaded a cover video.
He's the friend you need.
That's me.
First indeed.
Guy, that's me. Who
which one they say there?
I had one line in this movie. And I said it twice. A pal's
got the creep. Nice.
Look out, Spike! It's trying to become an anime!
Why, you could use a friend.
Do I hear a goddamn
I am the Batman.
Such a good song.
Covered in dirt and muck. But now your fate is changing.
Do bring me the fainting couch.
This is straight up Aladdin. I'm your
pal, you're a me. Oh, yeah, it is.
That's my favorite part.
You're a pal.
Aladdin coming out in May. That looks a little odd. I don't know how it's gonna do, but I hope it's good.
See, all you have to do is sing to them, and they'll literally walk into the Rainbow Factory.
It's a small thing.
Yeah, they are contractually really obligated to follow along.
In the original song, there was this awesome, like, kind of ramp up in the end of the song, and it was awesome, but I guess some, you know, higher up didn't like the way it ended. Good job, Dan.
Oh.
I think you gotta.
That's sad. Producers ruin a lot of things. It's sad.
He said the name of the thing!
He did the title drop! Everyone take a shot!
Apologies for the state of my letterbox. I wasn't expecting that.
Apologies for the smell of my toilet. I can't flush.
Not like the queen of the lion.
You're stepping in my poop right now.
Oh my.
It's clump.
I knew it! I knew they were gonna do that!
No, I'm sorry. That's just not as good as a Clue reference.
Do I ever say what happens to a fresh pony?
Ooh, I like the fruit in here.
Real hard!
I don't know anything!
If you don't talk, I'm gonna throw all your stuff on the floor!
I'm gonna plug in your gills!
Shark? Why?
Why not?
You're here.
Wow. She's good.
Whenever we see Tempest in the movie, we hear the instrumental part of Open Your Eyes.
She's like the guy from Psych.
I didn't notice that the first few times.
Just seeing all the little clues in the environment.
Friends with
friends?
Oh, that's Tempest's trigger word. Don't speak the F word.
Well, Netflix paid like $100 million for Friends, so it's pretty powerful.
Got karate.
Fishman just got dropped!
Drop the bass.
You're a good addition to this movie.
I wonder if she's like those little cars that you have where you have to make the wheels go, and it goes,
What rating is this movie to show like, oh, I'm gonna freaking electrocute you till you freaking tell me where these other horses are? It's just,
PG can get you a lot of ground.
Like
as we've learned.
Fade into the lamps.
I like that crossfade.
You can get some death, some violence.
I'll show ya!
No, I don't need you, Sonic Rainbow.
Some innuendo.
In my place.
Hotels at BronyCon in a nutshell.
Oh my god, this island from SpongeBob.
Oh, who is a little pony under the sea?
There you go.
Who did not place me victory at the Super Bowl?
See me, cause I don't think that they'd understand. Unless a Tumblr, because Tumblr likes that kinky interspecies relationship bullshit like this movie is trying to promote with a cat. And trying to fall in love and Rarity.
Hey, look.
Do you have pretty good chemistry even though they were only on screen for 15 seconds and I can't believe I'm about to run out of air. Damn movie.
This is like.
I ain't gonna kink shame over here.
She's thirsty for you.
Don't thank me. Really?
Uh-huh.
I feel sure guilty for something I do all the time.
That is a remarkably fast heel-to-face turn.
We need the queen.
Very,
of
very fast. That's
so you need silver.
The resolutions in this movie.
Hippos.
Why did they leave
happen
that little funny
pretty quickly?
Queen of the hippos things on for so long.
No one knows where they are.
What happened there? Was that the very first take or something?
Mountain right outside the window.
Yeah, either flipped to the page. No one knows. where they are.
Cage. What kid's movie would be complete without a good dose of slavery?
I have a burrito receipt next to me I just used to crumple there.
I knew it!
Oh, don't act so concerned, Capper. You knew exactly what you were doing.
You jerk!
I'm worth so much more than what you got for me.
My little holy roly.
He said the thing again!
This guy's just here. He's odd. I don't know why he's here.
He's actually dead.
Not bad!
And ponies can't kill anyone. But you'd be surprised what you can live through!
You won't be scared now, pony.
Yeah.
Shut up!
There's a whole lot of torture, but no killing.
Just cut every Grubber line from this movie and
it'll be so much. That's immorality.
You know, there's a good idea for a fan edit. Just edit out Grubber.
That's a pretty good edit, honestly. I haven't seen Pirates 2 in a long time. It was a fun scene, for sure.
Dead. Dead. Dead.
It's very polite of Applejack.
Just don't let go.
Hit before she actually talks. Better chance of biting her tongue.
That G-Force would do some potential damage. That scene looked really weird. That
really
one specifically.
They're using the 2D animation with like the 3D environments.
Didn't look
well most of the time.
Too well with their hooves on the boards. Perspective was a little odd.
Oh no, she's dead.
Whew, their momentum specifically was just not quite right.
Did you see The Amazing Spider-Man 2? That with the whiplash would kill you alone.
So close.
Far From Home's coming out soon. Jake Gyllenhaal.
Carrying her, but then just
my waifu.
Specifically, a airboat.
Stop.
Hate you so much. So very, very much.
Look, he's growing on me.
Oh, you're just jealous.
In this fifth time around.
Last time we trusted some pony.
What's so hard about everybody?
He wasn't a pony, Twilight. He was a cat.
You can't trust anybody who's not like you.
It's Ed from The Lion King.
We scar him. Emotionally.
That one's a good joke. I like that one too.
Okay, that was pretty funny.
That's just a good joke.
You know how we scar them emotionally? The last season is going to be next year.
We show them the movie.
It's gonna be over.
No.
Gen 4 is
go away.
Next
year. Paleo.
That's how you.
I'm gonna skip
emotion.
Your scene.
They're done. Next year they're done. No more ponies. Forever.
I mean, there's more ponies.
It's still gonna be Generation 5, but it's not gonna be Generation 4. It's gonna be done next year.
Look, Gen 8 is gonna be pretty cool. We'll get there in 20 years.
Rainbow Dash is super fast. Twilight can teleport and shoot beams like ridiculously. Rarity can shoot beams. And Fluttershy freaking wrestles bears. All right, it's just a thing right there. And Spike's a dragon. Like, you have like the Avengers of cartoon children right there. Just fight.
And Spike can be used as a mechanism for distraction or bargaining.
One organ and buff on him.
Throw them overboard.
Oh no!
I like that the Storm King symbol looks like the Halo sword.
Will that really work? I mean, like, three of them have wings.
That's not so bad.
Yeah, I mean,
said.
If we tie cement blocks to them, maybe.
Okay, they've been saved by union rules.
Union jobs, am I right?
Hey, you know, if they got unions, then
Applejack is actually eating the food that they gave him.
Of course.
They're not Applejack completely authoritarian here.
That is just such attention to detail. I love it.
Stop for a lunch.
Look, AJ eats gruel for a living.
That was great.
That's a great animation there.
One break a day for meals, and it's back to hauling goods.
Storm King is almost as hard on these birds as Jeff Bezos and Amazon are on their workers. Topical.
Hey, you don't see those birds wearing adult diapers.
That's another good joke.
They apparently have access. Well, they can't just pee off the side of the ship, I guess.
I wonder if that would hold up in court.
Also, they can fly.
Pirate Bay guys to change their name right away.
You can be awesome again.
Rainbow Dash is piracy, which is not a victimless crime. The Blu-ray says so.
Isn't a good time for us. I know the world can't get you down.
Don't download this song.
Meet those fears and doubts, so just squash them.
So they don't have a lot of stuff on that ship.
Awesome. It's time to be so awesome.
The moral grade.
I like the clapping in this song, but
sway.
I don't like the song very much. You of who
you are. Life's too short not to live a life of crime. Good lesson for the kiddies.
Like a tale still yet to be told.
I do really love the variety of character designs in this movie. It's really
visually cool stuff. And they can make toys if they wanted to.
I'm a little jealous of you.
I like Zoe Saldana.
You get to do a duet with Green Girl.
Hey, she's been green, she's been blue, she's been green again in Guardians. Depending on how far away that was thrown, that was kind of close for comfort.
This is my favorite
song. Spike can work that tongue, apparently.
This parrot pirate song is so fun.
This is really fun. It's like really jolly. Oh yeah, that shit is hype. I love this. Love it, love it, love it.
I do like, I like the instrumentation a lot.
Parrot, he gets it.
Woo, they'll never see us coming.
That is a pretty cool airship design, but I've never seen a Zeppelin with plumage.
That you've never lived, sir.
Twilight seems so anxious throughout this entire movie, but I can kind of see why.
Yeah, because she's correct. Her friends are being dumb.
That was cool!
I'm actually really happy we can see the rainboom in a cinematic release, HD, with all these effects. This is really
cool. Yeah.
This is the first time we've seen the sonic rainboom since the last time we've seen it.
Technically correct.
What is wrong with that?
What does the bird pirate have to say about it?
That is such a stark, like, contrast. Like, you got this really well-composed song.
What is that? Where did you get that?
Okay, but how could she have possibly known for sure that's them?
Ha ha, bunny? Or ha ha?
It's more like ha ha. Oh, no fair. Their ship is far.
I can tell you jokes. I know jokes.
To contrast what's about to happen.
Captain!
Yeah, yeah?
You think she saw my sonic rainbow?
All right.
Are you kidding me?
My friends are fucking idiots in this movie.
Rainbow, you're voted off the island.
Fools.
Goodbye.
The ponies are merchandise.
He wasn't lying about the rebranding.
All right, let's see. The Storm King's leadership is an authoritarian organization that's against creativity and fun.
Yeah.
They provide union jobs. They insist on doing things by the book.
Exactly.
And they sell toys. I mean, obviously the Storm King is a reference to Mattel, right?
Help them get their mojo.
All right.
Mojo, baby.
Exactly. You nailed it on the head, little shy.
She's stressless.
She's stressless.
Oh, yeah.
She's got this.
We've got this. You've got this.
Hey, isn't that what that bad guy from that
We've got this together.
I got this. I got this.
Your ship is going down.
Oh no, not my ship.
Hey, we got insurance on that. Flutterdash, solid ship. 8 out of 10, I'm okay with it.
We just saw Pinky accept that she's gonna die.
Pinky has completely lost her mind.
I embrace the sweet kiss of
Fluttershy
death.
Over there like, what the hey is wrong with you, Pinky?
Fluttershy, you have wings!
Don't worry, she'll figure it out eventually.
That's pretty funny.
Priorities are important.
You gotta hit that falsetto rarity. Otherwise, why even dying's not even worth it? Unless you're beautiful when you do it.
Could have just teleported them all to the ground.
For Heimlich maneuver of justice.
Pretty cool. Wouldn't work.
I guess I would have experience with
Look, let's not bring physics into this. The moment we bring physics into this series,
another sonic rainbow.
The entire thing, world dies.
Cake, some sprinkles. Oh yeah, and I found this too.
Good lord, is there anything Pinky doesn't make worse in this flick?
That's my bad. I didn't. That's my bad.
Hey, she makes a nice song here in a little bit.
I like him.
About your betrayal.
Don't worry. Cats always land on their feet.
I'm gonna take all 9 of your lives.
That's messed up.
Why did I bother buying this?
We're going to forgive her, aren't we?
I hope that toy was a solid construction.
I simply cannot even!
Tabitha.
What is a man?
Your fault.
So beautiful. Such great.
And the Oscar goes to.
It's the damn thing.
Lady Gaga, wow, huh?
Story.
Pretty impressive construction for non-magical creatures.
Is there any pony home?
Yeah, you're half right.
Nope, this place is antique.
Pinky's so...
Not even any roly-polies on the ground.
She's, like, actually insane.
Celestia, the map.
In fairness, Celestia's been wrong before.
This is true, she's actually often wrong in times of dire emergencies.
Siren.
I'll be remiss if I didn't mention the derpy glyphs. It's probably an ancient prophecy about the true Equestria.
She's gone!
Her mane is
the real queen! Pinky's got an auto-dry function.
She's still better off than Men in Black, too.
Yeah. Men in Black International's coming out. That's got Thor and Valkyrie.
No! It's so weird that, like, Twilight looks at them and is like, you know, I could probably save ourselves right now, but I'd just die.
Drowning is known as one of the most painful ways to die.
You know, after all the crap you've all put me through, I think it's worth it to die as long as you guys do, too.
Nice.
Okay.
Good joke. Good joke.
Yeah, I just wanted to die.
How do I know I can trust you?
We're the main character.
And we need their help.
Applejack's hat.
Do you see how many colors we collectively have?
Twilight. That's cute.
So
I can't swim.
Oh, wait, that's the Freddy and Jason song, not the Sea Ponies. Wait, which one is it?
Shoo-be-doop.
I like how Rainbow's the slowest swimmer, even though she's the fastest flyer. That's kind of clever.
Call upon the sea ponies. I never noticed that.
That's pretty cool.
Oh, that's
slow dash.
I mean, for all my negative criticism of this movie, the cinematography is beautiful.
Yeah, or whatever you call it when it's artificially camera.
Done.
What are you doing? You were supposed to kill him.
God!
Pop their bubbles.
I'm gonna say this far, then your guards are asleep at their post.
Don't you dare.
That's, you know, a good point.
Them.
What? You just said that you knew. What kind of tease are you?
Once upon a time.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped and turned upside
Our
down.
Our city got seriously flipped on upside like down.
We were the hippogriffs.
And now you're like hippocampuses, which is even better.
Do hippogriffs even count?
It's got an extra syllable.
Sea ponies.
Is that what they're called? Hippocampuses? Or is that a part of the brain?
Hippocampi.
What is a hippogriff? The only way I remember a hippogriff is from Harry Potter 3.
It's the pearl.
Yeah, Azkaban's a good film.
Every time I take
kind of turning point of the series.
Abandon your entire city and fled?
We just did the same thing. We have so much in common.
Yeah.
What?
Where are you?
What? I love your
movie. G.I. Joe!
We didn't flee, we swam! You know, in order to flee.
We must
fight
to run away.
That's the brilliance here.
Why does Hasbro hate ponies?
Why do they hate us? Why do they want us to suffer?
See, I told you the ponies were merchandise.
This is our
like
punishment.
Their little designs and stuff like that. Like, I like how Rainbow Dash has like more sharp fins than the other ones, and then others have like more smooth and fishy looking.
All of
ones.
Our collective transgressions from the past right 9 years, 8 years, 8.5 years.
Maybe you should untie your tail first.
I'll race you to that coral.
I guess 7 years when the movie came out, but...
Why would they know how to swim? Jason's flesh eyes.
It's still punishing us today, so it counts.
Of course.
It's really, Spike is really good here.
No respect.
Even the magic hates him.
We could transform every pony at home into something powerful enough to face the Storm King's army.
You know, Twilight can already do that with the same spell she used with the Breezies. Just find a dragon, turn a bunch of ponies into dragons, then crush the Storm King. Easy peasy.
Where'd the rainbow power go?
An even easier method would be to ask Discord to snap his fingers and fix everything.
Can we find the rainbow powers? Are they hidden somewhere? I mean, because they took out T-Rex and he was probably the strongest villain we've had.
Hippogriff Koo, who's with me?
We've come all this way.
Why won't you give us the only thing that's saving you from the Storm King? You don't even know us.
Time for my pony rap.
You're so selfish.
Say, I'm a badder sea pony, don't get in my way. I got magic like none that you ever seen. So don't get in my way, or I'll slap you with my sea pony fins.
French
friendship bracelets out of shell.
I wanted to let that one speak for itself. I enjoy it.
Shrimp soup, shrimp stew.
Yeah. Oh, like in Shell City in the SpongeBob movie. Yeah, everything was made out of, like, shells and, like, dead sea animals.
We do not need another Pinkie Pie.
Shall we? And Sheldon?
But what if we had one anyway?
I'll get
and they sang together.
So you can go home.
Aw, poor little Hippogriff doesn't have any friends because she acts too insane.
Or you could have her turn them into giant dragons.
I know exactly how she feels.
Look, this is... Don't...
Oh, no.
With every magic is very convenient to the plot. Bubbles,
it's not just like procedurally generated or something.
That's, can't just make really magic cool. Do anything, hey, Silver Quill. That's crazy.
It's Pinkie Pie.
Suspicious.
That's my Twilight, always controlling people.
I'm counting on it.
She learned it from the best. She's been around Starlight for a while now.
See, those are scheme eyes.
It's probably for the best.
You know what would also be for the best? A coup. No, not a coup.
Long ago!
Though he would be a better villain than the Storm King.
We've got a couple minutes and
Aku is a classic villain. Time to
play. So we're gonna make you miss
us. Mako is classic actor.
We've got a couple minutes for a song, and that's about it. One small thing and you will see
the start of something big for you and me. Of all
yeah.
The persuasions in this movie, this one's the most believable.
Yeah.
Dolphins!
That was super fun. Yay, we made Paleo happy. 10 out of 10 movie.
To dragons.
Except they're underwater, so it's like more of a muffled clap.
More random laughing to contrast what's about to happen.
Boogish.
One small thing.
Boogish.
No, that would be too cool. We know what to do. Here, have the pearl.
Here's access to our armory of Transformers.
Get out of that torpedo!
Tentacles, eh?
I've seen enough.
Thank you, Japan.
That's exactly what I'm gonna say.
Why? Why, Twilight?
Twilight done goofed.
They're doing so good.
Oh my gosh! I didn't see that coming! That is really messed up.
I think a lot of people that Twilight is just straight up stealing the pearl, but I actually kind of like this part of the movie. I don't think it's so much out of character as it is a display of desperation. Twilight's under a lot
of pressure. Yeah, in all fairness to her, her friends screwed up everything else so far.
Plot twist. I'm actually like, that threw me off. That threw me off.
She was putting country above world.
Twilight, you dinkhead. You're supposed to be the magic of friendships.
You don't deserve to live.
So you drown!
You do not deserve this giant Toblerone.
We're gonna turn you all back into ponies, underwater, in the depths, where the pressure is highest.
Time, but I think...
And it'll take you a long time to get back to the surface. Good luck!
I love this moment right here. We're hit with the bombshell about Twilight committing a crime, and then we have this rather long and very intentional pause. It's a sign of good restraint and good cinematic pacing.
And they set up scenes well in this thing.
The only way to save Equestria. Except it wasn't!
This is my favorite scene in the entire movie.
You just wanted us to distract her!
It's a decent confrontation.
We're gonna be debating this one for a while.
Breakdown of friends here.
We are not enough.
In the real world, I kind of agree with Twilight's reasoning here. As a Navy guy, the initial reaction for me isn't talking to this person will make them see things my way. It's this person is probably going to try to kill me unless I am prepared to do the same.
The only thing that stopped us?
Good perspective.
I honestly don't know why, but ponies are
Twilight did
the best thing in my life.
Not have
I don't know why.
I would have been better
much
off
reason to believe. There was another option in this situation here.
Bitch alert!
Man, like, I love, like, intense emotions like that in the movies.
It was in that moment Twilight realized she fucked up.
I can't talk to you right now.
Oh,
God. That's a rough moment.
So real.
I'm not gonna hug you yet.
It's a rough one.
From you. Thank you. We'll talk about that later.
Oh. She's so sad. Applejack is... bitter.
But I feel it. Man, damn.
Applejack's not going to give you any benefits of any doubts.
Friends are having to question that ideal.
Pinky is acting very much like her season one self.
And if you never question ideals for your own values,
Pinky is like the second main character of this movie.
Flanderized her. And they do have moments of that here, but they really toned him down, especially in this scene. And I just got to say, I absolutely appreciate
that. Yeah, as such,
that.
She's
that
not.
Little nuances like that, I truly do.
Totally love. Crazy
this
here.
This is an important part of growing up.
She's pretty played down, all things considered.
This shows that Spike is actually her best friend.
You know, we have a really good moment for Spike right here. Best of all,
it is good.
Not explained blatantly to the audience like some other scenes. But anyway, we see him torn.
It's a genuinely good Spike moment.
And the pony, which is basically his mother. The moment passes like that, but for a brief second, he considers his options, then he decides to go comfort Twilight. That's nice. Yeah. This is the sort of thing only fans like us would really appreciate, perhaps, but it's these moments which make the movie in my
little
opinion.
Little Shy, are you gatekeeping My Little Pony plot points?
We'll figure it out.
This is why Spike,
yeah, Spike chooses family over friends.
Anything up for the team, and
essentially.
The sticking with Twilight.
It's all my fault.
This is some of the best crying animation.
It was good.
That's a really weird thing to
like
say.
Like around the lips, the chin, like
and been attached to.
And biting
so,
the lips.
You know, like seeing Twilight cry right here is just excellent. I love it.
It looked really good. It
flows in the face and with the voice acting as well. And it just, it's a really good cry.
Yeah.
It's weird to say that I love to see a character cry.
The acting, that Tara really Strong, she might go like somewhere someday.
It feels like a really weird thing to compliment, but it's, I think they did a very good job.
Hey, it's the best crying since Tobey Maguire in Spider-Man.
That emotion that that character is feeling.
Do they put people
that could hold high school student
the least qualified for because they can learn the most about it? That sounded like a joke initially, but now I'm actually thinking about that.
Yeah. Throw him into the fire head first.
Stealthy.
He gave someone third degree.
That blood. Ship just snuck up on me.
Anti-magic metal. Game changer.
That's a pretty powerful cage if it can hold Twilight.
I wouldn't do that.
Yeah, just that's magic absorbing
friendship.
Polycarbonate.
With no friends.
What a loser.
You're a pony. Just like me.
Twilight.
Emily Blunt does some good line reads in this movie.
Speciesism in this movie.
I like that chuckle.
Weird. I don't expect the protagonist to have this kind of mindset.
Yeah, like, you're one of us!
Learned a lesson.
We should be together!
Comes the song! The one everybody loves!
Ooh, a villain song!
Let's do it! Give me them googly eyes! Eyes!
Shoutouts to the shadows of Tempest in this shot having horns. Probably deep and mean stuff. Among the mighty.
This one does look pretty good. Open up your eyes! Your eyes. There we go. There it is.
Repetitive, but it sounds really good.
Good song is good.
Time to grow up and get
it's got some oomph to it.
Cynicism and wisdom are often confused for one another.
Oh, here's the story.
I like that they did the little 2D chibi sequence here. It's
yeah.
A nice callback to those little sequences they did.
The pointy ponies. That's kind of, that's, that man, imagine like
thing broken off. Oh, F.
There was good use of 3D.
Don't say that's thing really like that, Jax.
Starlight.
You know, a lot of the backgrounds have too much 3D that sticks out like a sore thumb, but right there, in that moment with the horn floating through black space, that
but imagine
really good.
Seeing,
so
holding part of
this
your
song
bone.
Is a beautiful song. Like, she,
after it broke off of you.
Getting effed up by a bear like that, it's just, ugh, I love this.
Look, bears are no joke. Be sure to know what kind of bears are in your area, because some of them you want to play dead, some of them you don't.
Get away from this freak. She's an OC from Pony Creator.
I'm deep and brooding. And I have a dark past.
Unicorn Mohawk Applejack. Back to the very start of the movie. It's all linked.
Best way to
Applejack is secretly a shapeshifter.
Like
a transformer, you might say.
Just enough information to provide a solid narrative, but also vague enough for us to fill in the blanks.
This is why Tempest is so much better as a villain in this movie than Storm King, because she's actually like sympathetic and she actually has a story. And she shows up most of the time.
Or the writers lucked out and were lazy, but it worked.
One of my biggest disappointments for the movie. This is all we see of Ponyville.
Aww.
I think that's downright tragic.
And it's
the
smoking.
The songs in this movie were so good!
Friend, abandon me when times got tough.
This is your opportunity.
The soundtrack does kind of outlive the film itself.
Has failed you too.
Face it, princess. Friendship is not magic.
I failed friendship.
There it is.
There it is.
Formulaic anecdote 101.
No, I'm gonna say it was a group.
Look, failure. It's formulaic for a reason, Gabe.
That's pretty bad that you failed friendship. That's really.
You're in a formulaic
bad.
Movie. You gotta black. Throw in the formulaic lines.
Black. Ooh.
Such a mistake.
She has the hiccups.
Like, there was one person who did all the animation for the crying. That one person really loves.
Twilight!
When we find you, we will kill you.
We'll never catch you.
It's really the voice director, wouldn't it be?
No way to defeat those monsters.
Give me a nice little.
Oh, well.
Well, look what the cat dragged in.
That literally doesn't make sense.
Break out of the tightest situations.
Wait, am I missing something? Wasn't
unless he's referring to his belongings
I mean,
that he dragged with him.
We know he's a good guy and all because he's a main character, but the last time the ponies saw Capper, he betrayed them. Did they just forget that or what?
Now don't get too excited. He's just talking about us.
Applejack. Shaw.
Like Applejack's realistic attitude here.
I somehow
got back our ire.
No heads in the clouds when you're stuck on the ground.
We're ready to kick some ire.
Remember, Gabe, PG. You probably could get away with that in this movie and maintain the rating.
Is that like the Brazilian Jesus in the background?
Brazilian Jesus.
It's Brazilian Jesus.
Hello!
Appreciate it, but you could have grabbed
it. It looks kind of like a cross.
Talk things over with Shelly and Sheldon, and they pointed out that.
I'm insane. So let's do this.
You were just trying to help your friends.
Moral of the story.
Turns out, no I am not fit for society, so let's go, usurp a king.
And want to help you out in the end. No, wait, that makes no sense.
That's it, right?
Look, they're good. They're all good.
Else?
Don't worry about it. Don't worry. They're all.
Go get the
everyone's
the
good
billboard.
Now.
Spy gets every creature. None of these are ponies.
Tally ho! It is I, Friendship Jeremy, here to help you on your quest to defeat the Storm King.
With my friendship sword.
With all those masks on, it looks like a some kind of S&M sex colony.
Yeah.
Again.
And it's out in the open too.
Aloe and Lotus are like actually still.
Not even a dungeon.
Just. For the goons.
Through the storms, through the clouds, the rain.
Yeah, sneak peek.
Oh, they caught Sia.
Songbird Serenade can sing without a tune, even without a microphone.
Couldn't Sia that coming.
You can understand.
So we just play a little ukulele beside her and upload it to my Snap story. I don't know how to use social media.
He sounds like.
I asked you to sing Madonna, not Sia.
I love that Sia just all of a sudden burst out into song, and then some dude just was like, shut up. I think if I was ever...
I like to imagine she's been singing that verse the entire time.
Face off. I've had nothing else to do.
Did he just say knees, knees, stick?
Yeah. That's his favorite song. He wants to hear that one, not whatever she's singing. That Viva scene's right out of the ring.
Actually looking at you. I mean, she's got all that hair.
I imagine this at a convention where everyone gets locked up and they're like, oh, not the VAs.
Take
the
community guests.
They're expendable.
Yeah. Oh.
She's actually blind, it turns out.
Make a shirt out of this.
She's
I
like Toph.
Friendship festival, but all I got was enslaved.
What can you really do?
Hey, look who showed up!
Wow, Storm King, you
I can generate millions of dollars in revenue!
I feel like Tyrik would have gotten the job done already. I know Tyrik liked to gloat, but this guy just seems way too goofy.
Yeah, Tyrik would flex on you, but hey.
I'll admit, that was a smart move.
Quality flex.
I like bidding!
On eBay!
What are you supposed to be?
I'm supposed to be Princess Twilight, can't you tell by my costume?
I'm the Princess of Friendship.
I'm a very recognizable design.
He's responding the same way we all did.
I don't like
you like branding, you should like me.
Stay clear of Fluttershy then.
Check out the light show.
Does Storm King have any idea what he wants to do?
He's just a villain who wants power.
Actually, kind of first rate. What else does it do?
I don't know. Why don't you ask T-Rex?
Well, you just broke rule one of the villain handbook. You freed your prisoner.
Oh, here we go. It's the Storm King staff is finally fully powered. Here we go.
That's like a laser gun sound effect from a 1998 Windows PC game.
The equestrian calendar is screwed.
Twilight did this jerk better.
Yeah, we just got a year went by all of a sudden. It's crazy.
He's only in the minute for 2 minutes.
I mean, as bad guys go, I kind of like him.
Who wouldn't be doing just this with this power?
Bring this here, cake.
I mean, I would do that after I crushed my enemies, at least.
So what does this mean about opalescence?
It's kind of like that Goofy and Pluto sort of situation.
Yeah.
Congratulations on subduing defenseless pastel ponies, cake.
Ooh.
I haven't seen Pluto in Kingdom Hearts 3.
Nice.
Quit looking so happy. You ain't fooling no pony.
Oh.
Wow. There it is.
It's cute.
I will say, she commits to it.
Don't mind.
Yeah, Pinky's a method actor. Actress. Actor.
That was it. That's
gender neutral. Let's go with
that. This whole movie's been building to that moment. All those cake jokes just so Grubber could blow their cover. He's such a vital character.
Look, Michael Pena is...
really appreciate the
my star is my light. Where?
Gorgonites, fight!
She
I need to rewatch that.
This is not the same army that conquered Canterlot.
Nice.
I don't think it goes forward.
That's some really
violence area, nor does it go into the actual
strong ribbon
area. It's kind of somewhere in the awkward middle.
Dead.
Was that?
That went straight through the brain.
Through his head?
Quentin Tarantino approved.
Literally just murdered someone.
In the Danganronpa series, blood is literally that exact shade of pink.
That wasn't frosting on the wall. That...
Brains.
Brain matter.
Pinkie Pie owns it.
Pure and simple.
So Pinky is demonic.
That's
apparently.
All murder. Every cupcake there is lethal.
You seem tense. Do you want to talk about
I love this joke.
Say no to that face.
I love
they
this so much.
Fix all problems with talking in equestria.
Her face is so good there.
Aw, that's kind of cute.
I always appreciate when they do this kind of thing.
This is the
she's
only
so nice.
Fluttershy has done the entire movie.
It is. Let her have it. Let her own it.
Something.
Have someone as kind and
unlike Applejack.
Fluttershy just to, like talk.
What
to
does she do? She ate food. Like, good job, Applejack.
The most cathartic experience of life. I envy that monster.
Oh, I, yes, we're gonna get a fire show in a second here.
My butt cheek?
Flamethrower Spike.
Spike, why don't you always do that?
Here it is, zoom in. Those guys are not having a good day.
God. I like how these guards are getting like cupcakes to the face and a slap on the wrist and like...
A talking to, a therapy session.
And this one guard gets incinerated. Oh, don't worry, they're just playing.
It's the magic of...
Really the short end of the stick here.
And flowers and ponies and
bleh.
Hey, don't steal my snark. It's all I have.
I still love the Storm King, and I wish he was in the movie longer than he was.
Yeah, give us a little more Storm King. Would have been really nice.
It's been a while since they've had a fun villain.
He's kind of underused.
I'm so totally over the cute pony thing.
Love to agree with you, man, but it still works on me sometimes.
And then they had two more seasons.
Oh, right. His name is the Storm King. We should throw a storm in there before the movie's over.
Yeah. Gotta live up to it.
Excellent.
That's what you do. Everyone's named after a very specific thing in this universe. It's what they do.
The Storm King.
Finally on brand.
We had an agreement.
Now I've accomplished my one and only goal in life.
I used you.
I guess I'm done.
That's kind of what I do.
I mean, we didn't really establish, like, what you do because you're barely a character.
You're not the used king.
For spelling that out, movie. We probably wouldn't have been able to figure that one out.
But you promised.
Dude, you are sending up all the defeat flags.
Oh. Whoops.
It's always funny to me when a villain does this kind
Tempest
of thing.
Tempest is like, oh, thanks for giving me the thumbs up.
Someone right where you want them.
To turn on you.
Give them the one thing that they're asking for. And instead you have to be a dick and you literally screw yourself over.
Yeah.
Come on, Twilight!
Moral quandary!
It's like deciding to save Hank in Detroit
Seriously,
Become Human.
Come on.
Always save Hank.
I know this is a dramatic moment and all, but I can't help but laugh at the idea of Hooves having grip. Even after all these years, it's still funny to see ponies hold on to things.
I mean, Pinky can climb walls.
Don't you see, Steven?
Somebody has to kill the babysitter.
That's what friends do.
Befriending the villain is kind of an overused
trope. They hold hands.
But I really do think Tempest is one of the better examples of it. Of all the overused cliches in the movie, this one's the most passable. I think that was a compliment.
Like, her development
quickly
is surprisingly good in the face of Storm King not having any
friends.
I hope that we can still be friends.
I don't think I'm there yet, boss.
Well, I am. Okay.
Just
do it! Just...
Okay.
Thank you for the restraint, Gabe.
I don't like that. It's a reference to the first episode.
To the moon!
How many scary faces she's made.
Bullseye!
Hey now, that's offensive to bulls.
I was wrong to...
I mean, Fluttershy got some of that flank in the face.
Make up later!
Thank you, Rainbow Dash! Thank you!
You know, finally someone says it.
It was like, yeah, we don't have time for those friendship speeches. Let's get this shit done, alright? Do that afterward. I love that.
Like, this is what the villain's doing, is talking instead of action.
You, that's a cursed saying!
You've got this!
Oh no! Alright!
No. We've got this.
He's transforming.
Together.
Da-da-da-da-da.
Oh, see,
we got this together.
The movie. There's your continuity, Silver Quill.
See, there's that's the big circle of life right there.
Stop!
This would be much more terrifying if we didn't see what he was talking about.
No, that's my stuff.
They're just climbing the aggro crag. Nice. And then Twilight pops up in a different movie.
The end.
Spike, I don't think we're in Equestria anymore. Guys,
I can't believe they actually killed off Twilight Sparkle.
I can't believe
that's pretty crazy.
They killed off their main character.
It's been a weird season since then.
Hold it in. Just keep going.
And Principal Starlight.
Applejack, stop. You're not allowed to cry on the outside.
Yeah, after Mary Poppins Returns, this is
Mary Poppins.
Kind of exactly what we're doing here.
Have you accepted Twilight Sparkle as your lord and savior?
Oh my god, Twilight didn't die. I never would have guessed.
No! Also, ooh, this kill here is pretty solid.
Oh, crap.
Oh, this won't end well.
This one's brutal. Not as brutal as the guy getting incinerated, but man, he...
Oh my-
get smashed.
Oh my god!
Yeah.
I just killed him.
Take that, all you shows that don't...
Hella dead.
He is
finish off their villains.
...percent D-E-D dead.
Hardly newly.
Oh! That was really intense!
That could have been you, Discord.
That's a pretty
This is like death to Hasbro.
Yeah.
Like, that's essentially body parts of a person.
Yeah.
Violent death. And like...
This happened to Piccolo once. It was, pretty interesting.
God. They are zooming in on the body, showing... Oh, no, it's busted. His head's busted. He's dead. His corpse is just completely... That's just ballsy of this damn movie, dude.
Hey, Storm King, nothing to lose your head over.
Oh, God, I love this film.
I think it's safe to say that Storm King and Tempest... broke up.
And we're done, ladies and gentlemen. It's all over.
It would be really bitter if they mixed that up with a lightning bolt.
Oh, thank God that worked. That was a 50-50% chance I was gonna like...
She wouldn't conduct it.
Destroy it into a million pieces.
Now, we fix everything.
Now we friend.
The script from Hasbro. Yeah, just fix everything. Use magic or something.
Then we
do whatever.
Dungeon for betrayal. We just need to build a dungeon.
We're gonna forgive her, aren't we?
We don't care. Just follow an arc.
Always.
Just do the thing.
Every time.
She committed treason.
Yes, Luna, you did miss something.
Princesses.
Princesses. Just doesn't roll off the tongue.
Princeye.
Once again, Celestia and Luna do absolutely nothing.
Hey, Celestia said hippo.
This truly is my little party.
Back to the shop.
Yeah, this is...
movie?
100%.
There's the hero of the movie. Yeah.
What the show is.
Feel better.
Best movie. 10 out of 10.
We saved Derpy.
It is amazing how little an invasion and enslavement affects this population.
And now to celebrate the fact that we're all still here in one piece.
Oh, they probably won't play much of the song, will they? That one's probably a bigger copyright issue.
Twilight and her friends.
Though it is on the same album, so maybe not.
And her friends, the other guys.
Twilight and the rest of them.
Did her voice just crack a little?
Way to go, guys!
That guy, who is that?
Bolt's bicep, my favorite. But ow.
Like, Vincent and Gabe haven't mentioned him, so I don't know who he is.
Last song in the movie, I guess. Where
I see love. You know, love.
I just criticize them for not animating the speakers moving, but they did. The speakers, I think, are actually vibrating ever so slightly. That's actually kind of.
Oh, amazing. Really? That'd be pretty cool. All right.
So low, but so high. I'm sorry, I can't understand a word she's saying.
Can you even understand what she's saying? You.
Hey, it's what Sia do.
Long but so high.
I have that hair.
it's pretty cool hairdo.
Hers looks better.
He's got a dye ears.
Big Dream Earl.
Oh, been eyes.
You must have rehearsed a lot of times to make sure I didn't fall off, because none of them can see.
It's very similar to the ending of Zootopia.
Well, that's what animated movies do these days.
There too? Holy crap, I've seen this movie a few times now, I have to admit, and this is the first time I just saw Derpy in that scene. Wow.
At least this one, like, they were already having a party, so the song makes sense in context. Zootopia did too, but some movies just, like, end, and then, hey, let's have a song.
You screwed over diplomatic relations by refusing to help.
I just don't think the critics appreciate how hard it is for ponies to dance. They don't.
They put their heart and soul into it. Derpy's very happy.
Derpy, no pony will stand next to her.
Oh.
No, strike that. No pony is worthy enough to stand next to her.
There we go. They fixed it there.
Most of the background ponies didn't talk was because they didn't want to sadly pay the other actors to, like, come and do the stuff for the movie.
Yeah.
But it's just, that's... It's sad in a way, and it makes sense why the bulk of the film was just the main six and other famous celebrity people, but again...
I mean, I'm pretty sure they paid the famous celebrities a lot more than they would have paid the one thing that never changes the actors from the show.
The party.
No kidding. This was like Apocalypse number 27.
Woo! I can see your rainbow!
Meanwhile, production backstage.
Oh my god, this wasn't on the schedule! Who's setting off the fireworks? Somebody tell me what's going on!
You know, I actually kind of appreciate the fact they didn't just have an easy magical solution for Tempest's horn.
Yeah.
They may have had a convoluted magical fix for literally everything.
That is pretty
else,
good.
At least they didn't take the lazy route where it matters most. Again, I think that was a compliment.
Yeah, we'll give you something. And a new ship was born!
Are they flirting right now?
Kiss!
Twilight's giving her the, like...
The glance that sailed a thousand sails.
Ignore all the fanatics screaming about shipping for a moment. This actually might be one of the most meaningful scenes of the entire movie. Tempest lets her guard down for a moment and smiles. Twilight catches her and holds eye contact until Tempest gives in and embraces the smile. It's over before you know it, but it might be one of the most important moments in Tempest's story.
You like Krabby Patties, don't you, Tempest?
You found happiness in finally finding a true friend. There. I think I got a compliment at last.
But sadly, hey,
you
we'll
did
never
it.
See Tempest again unless she appears in the final season.
It's a good breakdown.
Those one-time cameo things by Emily Blunt.
Actually, that's not.
Or a second movie. You never know.
My name is Maximus Decimus Meridius, commander of the armies of the North, general of the Felix Legions, loyal servant to the true Emperor Marcus Aurelius.
You know I'd buy it.
Father to a murdered son, husband to a murdered wife.
It's Fizzle Pop Berry Twist.
My name is Inigo Montoya.
The most
you killed my father.
The ass name I have ever heard.
Fizzle Pop Berry Twist. Oh.
So why do people keep calling her Tempest?
That's a good shake flavor. I like it.
Twist, y'all.
Here's our young little Fizzle Pop, growing up into her adolescent years.
You don't call me that anymore. You call me Tempest Shadow.
Oh, she's entering her Edgelord years.
I like Tempest. Tempest was the coolest.
Yeah.
Or. Berry Twist Twizzle Branch?
Barry Twist, comma, Fizzle Pop.
This land has ponies named Rakoku Fru Fru and Namby Pamby.
That's true. All right. I thought he made the first one up, but based on the second one, I mean, he did not. And then the Pointy Ponies!
Chibi credit sequence, which looks actually really nice.
It's good!
My Little Pony, the movie.
Woo! And then and there was no pony ever again.
Press the final button I didn't actually end up pressing. Twilight Sparkle, what do you have to say about this?
I have amazing friends who are there for me no matter what.
Hi, Starlight. Hi, Trixie.
Wow.
You didn't do anything.
Look, they were busy
the hungry hippo
gallivanting across the world in Trixie's wagon. Yeah,
this sounds like a celebration, too.
I actually like this song and the credits better than the Sia song.
Kristen Chenoweth and I worked together in the Music Man movie way back when.
Oh.
I danced in that movie for ABC Disney.
Wow.
Played Marion the Librarian.
That's cool.
It was a fun scene.
Howling at the moon, Discord. Howling at the moon, Discord.
Oh my god, they're displaying his corpse!
Yeah, it belongs in the museum. We have to remember the past or else we're gonna repeat it.
And Zoe Saldana as Gamora. I mean, Captain Solano.
I mean, Nate Thierry. Avatar 2 coming to a theater near you, 2021.
Dance that she did, like, in season 2.
Yeah! It's the best dance. Drives everyone away.
From a long way. And that was My Little Pony the movie. I think it was pretty good.
They misspelled
my yeah, it's fun.
Name in the credits.
Really? All right. Oh, nice. Are we gonna have a little zinger? Who's gonna zing? Of course. There we go. Shut up.
Shut up.
I'm done with you. That's 7 years bad luck, man. That was a long video. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, that was Bronies React to My Little Pony the movie, and I think an hour and a half video speaks for itself. For a subject matter this momentous, the movie is debatably the biggest thing that they've touched on the series. I did expect the cast to be a little more fleshed out, maybe two or three more people at least, but they did do well with what they had and managed an hour and a half of content regardless. On the whole, this Bronies React was a bit more straight-laced than a lot of them. You know, we had our snark, our sarcasm, self-deprecation, and some innuendo. But everyone was pretty down-to-earth in presentation and content. Though, as we've seen before, Viva definitely does put in some extra work into his skits, and I appreciate that. Vincent did not have a lot to say, this was not as big an inclusion as, say, Larson, but it was nice to hear some of the behind-the-scenes work and some background that both he and Gabe were able to provide. Generally, the talking points were pretty expected and not wildly different from what I think and what the fandom thinks. And this is a case where they did not have a whole lot to say after the credits, which may reflect how the movie was fairly solid, plus or minus good, all the way through, nothing that tipped it into incredibly bad or into Pixar-level quality. It was a fun time, and it absolutely has its redeeming qualities. And I suppose I could apply that to both the movie and this Bronies React. I'm super glad that Race and Pals are around still. I like seeing their spirit, I love seeing them at conventions. And this video was another example of why they're worth the time, even if it was an hour and a half of me yelling. So I am going to let my throat rest. Thank you, Race. Thank you, Gabe. Thank you, Viva. Thank you, everyone who was part of this. And thank you all for watching along, both to them and to me. Until next time, remember, you got this.